So I'd like to introduce today's topic, which is DC productivity and the traveling salesman. And our presenters today are Andrew Southgate and Dave Cole. Andrew is general manager of Lucas Systems EMEA. He's dialed in today from the UK. And Dave Cole is principal solutions consultant here at Lucas Systems, and he is here with me in Pittsburgh in the United States. With that, let me turn it over to Andrew.
John, good afternoon everyone and welcome. Behind this presentation is to describe a new approach to reducing travel in the DC to improve labor productivity, which is into a classic optimization challenge known as the Travelling Salesman Problem. The Travelling Salesman, let's talk about why travel is such a critical issue. The team to talk to in the DC environment is focused on reducing costs. And in, the typical DC, labor is by far the largest operating cost. The average DC operative time is spent traveling between warehouse locations. Reducing travel is the key to improving productivity and reining in labor costs. In this presentation, we're going to dive a little deeper into this travel challenge. I'm going to take a few minutes to talk about the issue and common solutions. And we'll bring in Dave to talk about a new tool available from Lucas, Dynamic Work Optimization, directly addresses the travel challenge and reduces travel time in picking by up to 50%. I'd like to mention the usual solutions, which directly address the travel challenge in different ways. Automation is obviously one approach. This forms such as conveyors, sorters, and goods to operative solutions of one kind or another. Another approach is slotting. Slotting is typically focused on getting the highest moving items in the optimal position for picking travel. Slotting is a best practice, as we know, but in many cases, it may only result in small incremental changes in productivity. At this point, I would like to bring in Dave to talk about another three approaches with the travel challenge: task giving, voice enablement, and process re-engineering. To you.
Yep. Thank you, Andrew. I'll start with task interleaving. Many folks have started to use task interleaving as a means of reducing travel that can make the users more productive on their return trip from, as an example, picking. As I drop something out of the dock, as I return back out to the area to pick, I can obviously take something with me or do something on my way back, or interleaving cycle counts with picking, therefore reducing travel. Another, as many of you are aware, voice enablement, where I improve productivity by enabling the guy to enter information, the folks to enter information through a voice application. The travel reduction is not there, but I'm improving productivity after the pick phase. Often we go into process re-engineering. We're just taking a look at the processes and re-engineering the processes to either reduce travel or reduce movements of the users. So what do you mean by process re-engineering? I'll start using an example. The best example I can think of is an e-commerce company that we've worked with. They have an average size DC, it's about 3,000 foot. Their orders were 2 to 3 lines each, typically. And the pickers would be picking pairs of shoes from one area, they'd be picking dresses from another area, and other types of accessories and so forth from other areas. They approached us to come look at their processes and to actually voice enable it. We looked at the process and said it needs more than just voice enablement. Their people were walking 5, maybe 10 miles a day on average, and it was obviously a tremendous waste of labor time. Using our mobile work execution system, we can let transition them to a zone-based picking without changing their WMS. Our system took their orders from the WMS, split orders across the different areas, and allowed them to pick the dresses, the accessories, the shoes separately, and coordinate the bring the orders together at the packing area. So using Lucas Move solution, which we'll talk about in a little bit, we were able to reassemble the orders using a sortation process at the end. So I'm going to go to this diagram you see right now, and we're showing here are the various differences. We're using picking as an example, but you can translate this to other processes within the warehouse. A typical picking process, creating batches. I've got a picker setting up something. In this example, we use carts, setting up their cart. We have picking to the cart, and then at the end, we stage carts or we drop off totes. We do something at the end, and then there's a packing process. We're going to focus the next few slides on the pick the cart area and what impacts we can have in that specific area. Enablement. And if you voice enablement, we mean taking a process, an existing process, and just layering voice over top of it. And many of you have probably looked at voice enablement, maybe use voice enablement, where I'm saving a lot of motions for the user at the pick phase, where I've got their hands and their eyes straight. So that impacts portion of time spent at the pick phase, but that can be as little as 20-30% of the total time, where their travel time is in that 70-80% of the time. So you can significantly reduce the pick put, but you're only attacking a small portion of the time spent of their day, which is picking. So back to what do we do with the travel? So, as the title of the presentation is the Travelling Salesman Problem, Willie Loman of The Death of a Salesman was, how do I get better? How do I get to see or visit more customers in the shortest path? This has been a problem that we've talked about in warehouse for years. How do you solve this? Most warehouses today, most warehouse systems do a pick path in location sequence and route the pickers through location sequence. If you've got pickers using paper pick lists where they have a list, they'll spend time looking at the list and try to figure out a shorter path. Many are very good at finding a shorter path, but they do spend time looking through a list to do that. WMS systems, directed processes, they are suboptimal. The workers often walking much more than they should. What we're going to talk about in the rest of this presentation is a new tool of dynamic work optimization that fits our larger solution, and we're going to talk about how we attack the traveling salesman problem. A couple terms is the system. The Lucas Engage is our work execution software and management dashboard. It uses information from a WMS to manage and orchestrate the picking, the put away, the other processes, the hands-on processes formed by workers in the DC. The pickers or other DC associates that are mobile use the Lucas Move mobile applications to perform their tasks. Moves can run on smartphones, standard warehouse devices, and features Jennifer Voice, which guides employees through their jobs using a speech recognition, but also uses barcode scanning and other data capture input technologies. Demo, which will be focused on the rest of this presentation, is an optional module within our Engage, and it has two primary components. It's got batch optimization, and it has path optimization. First, with the optimization portion of dynamic work optimization, typical batches are created with some rule-based fashion. Rules can be based on priority, where priority is defined by something as simple as first in, first out. And some others are more complex, maybe using gate time or a ship time, a carrier, or a ship via. So there are solutions out there that are using these various rules to create batches. Dynamic work optimization takes these rules into account and then uses mathematical models as well. And these are applied to create optimized batches. So this example, the next few slides, just a way to describe the batch optimization. Right at the bottom of this slide, you'll see orders, and they're in some type of priority order, 1 through N. And then the top thing will be the current batches we're putting it together. So a lot of batches just do FIFO. They'll take the top, and this is going to be 6 orders. They would take the top 6 orders that are in the list and apply them. Others may use, as we said earlier, some gate time rules and take the top based on gate times and calculations and throw it into the batch. So the distance is pretty much unpredictable. Distance on traveling is based on any layout of the warehouse or any calculations on the distance traveled. So with DW, we will seed the first batch with the highest priority order or orders. In this example, we're using one order. So the first order, 01, will be placed into the batch. Then math model runs to calculate the added distance, the additional distance that would be required to pick up the other orders up to N orders, whatever the N is set. And N can be all the orders in the system at time, or N can be restricted based on saying, I don't want to go too deep in my priority to put batches together, so I weight batching or my priority a little higher in my batches. So example, you'll see order 8. You have to pick order 8 without adding additional distance. So 8 is going to get added to the batch because I get it for 0 distance. When I do that, I don't have to recalculate the other distances because 8 was part of the trial I was getting for 1. So I look for the system now looks for the next better to put in, and 6 comes out as the next best order to put in the batch. And 6 is added to the batch. Path has been added to, so it recalculates dynamically the other distances or the other orders, the other additional distances. As you'll have seen, those values change at the bottom. And it can use this process to pick up the orders that batch together to create a optimal path. It predicts the distance for that path. So batching optimization algorithms and how it functions. And when we talk about dynamic here, the important part of the dynamicness of this is these calculations run in sub-second time. So these are running on whatever orders are in your system at the time and whatever orders have been permitted to be added to batches based on rules. So the user can be getting work or asking for work. And this subsequently takes into account all new orders. So in an example of an e-com world where orders are coming in all day long, it takes into account the orders that are coming in real time. So the batch optimization is the pick path optimization. Similar to the batch optimization, these also, the path optimization runs a dynamic sub-second time. Path in warehouse management systems has normally been in a fixed location sequence. And unfortunately, this usually leads to suboptimal traveling through the warehouse. And also, many DCs notice that their best pickers will plan their route with a few picks ahead in order to optimize their path. So they have to think about where they're going next. And it turns out to be out of the exceptions. Work optimization, attempt to make this rules by giving every picker a opportunity to reduce the travel path by calculating the best path for them. Additionally, things happen. There's volatility in a warehouse. There's things happen that will require real-time updates, and that's where the dynamicness of this path optimization comes into play. You may you'd be getting sent to or requested to go down an aisle that all of a sudden somebody just dropped a pallet, or there are multiple other users in that aisle. The user can tell the system to skip that aisle and in sub-second get a new path based on the fact that they're not going to travel down that aisle for now, and they'll come back to that aisle at a later time in the assignment. The other part of the dynamic piece is the starting point of the path. I just finished my last assignment, and I dropped my assignment. I staged my pallet at door 20 in my warehouse. The dynamicness of the system, the path optimization, can now create a batch and a path based on the fact that I'm starting at door 20 and give me an assignment that will be optimal for me starting from door 20. The next one I drop at door 1, if I was dropping this one at door 1, would be a different set of assignments or batches or orders in my batch to make an optimal path. There is a simulation tool that is showing the dynamicness of the path. So as you see the path, the little dotted line being drawn on the simulation, you see the path that the system is recommending for the user. In this example, the start point and end point are the same, but as I pointed out earlier, that could be moving up and down the various doors of the warehouse. If you go off to the right, there's a path a blue box in the lower right-hand corner that does the distances based on two calculations. One is it had done this in typical warehouse management system solution, which is location sequence. This example was the last one that ran was 405 foot. The optimized by dynamic work optimization is 23.8% less. In distance, it would be 308 feet for that example. And a fairly common number we see in the reduction of travel. And obviously, that's based on how your batches are put together and your warehouse locations and so we showed earlier. So earlier we talked about the voice enablement and impacting the pick put. And reduce that. We're now showing you what's the result if we also do significant travel reduction based on the dynamic work optimization. So as you see, we show significant improvement on the total of picking, which is both the travel and the time spent at a pick phase. You expect. Obviously, that's dependent on where you start and what improvements are available to be made based on where your starting point is. But the batch optimization side, we see 15 to 30% reduction in the travel. On the path optimization equivalently, or equally around 15, in this case, 40% in travel. So if you're putting the two of those together, you realize anywhere from 20 to 70% realistic numbers to realize in implementing or applying dynamic work optimization. In off of what I get if I was doing enablement at the pick face and improving my or making my users' hands and eyes free and reducing some of their movements at the pick face. So where does obviously we've in the example we've used picking because typically you know whereas picking is a large high percentage of my manpower and my therefore my cost my labor cost back picking the car is it's an ideal area for this because of the size of batches and the more flexibility in creating batches that you typically get out of batch pick to cart. Pick to pallet it can apply, particularly in where I'm doing multiple pallets to maybe a double or triple jack. I get additional batching, but I also can use the dynamic work optimization, path optimization for just the travel through the warehouse. And obviously in other applications such as put away, where can direct users on what to put away next based on where they've ended their previous assignment, replenishment, and CycleCon equally the same. Anywhere I have travel, I have a place to apply dynamic work optimization. To John now for questions and hopefully answers.
Thanks a lot, Dave. Yeah, we did get a couple of questions coming during the presentation. Once again, if you do have a question, use the Q&A box on WebEx to type it in, and that will come directly to us. Like I said, we have a few questions already. And the first one, let's see, what if the picker skips a location or a product is out of stock?
As I sort of mentioned earlier, that with the dynamic and the speed of the calculations that run behind the dynamic work optimization, that can be recalculated almost instantaneously. So if I skip a location or I get to an out-of-stock location, I can get a recalculated path based on that information.
Okay. This question, Andrew, why don't you take this one? Question, what if we aren't batch picking? Can we still use dynamic work optimization?
Yes, we can still use the dynamic work optimization tool for pick path optimization, even not batch picking. Our returns, although significant, will not be as great as if you were combining both, John.
Okay, thank you, Andrew. Let me paraphrase this question. We are in multiple locations. How does the dynamic work optimization tool select a location or create the batch if a product is available in multiple locations?
The work execution system, we're normally tied to a warehouse management system, and that question is really based on the ability or capabilities of the warehouse management system to allow us to take alternate locations. Many have evaluated the work from a specific location. Therefore, the direction of what location to pick from comes from the warehouse management systems. Others that will allow alternate location picking, then the dynamic work optimization can take that into account.
A couple more questions. We're right at our anticipated time, but we are going to take another couple of questions here. Andrew, maybe this one would be good for you. What about the e-com situation where new orders are being released throughout the day?
Sure. Good news, our dynamic work optimization tool is dynamic. Algorithms are designed to continuously recalculate as new orders are being received throughout the day, as existing orders are executed and completed.
Thank
okay,
you.
John?
And I think this will be our last question. Can you use dynamic work optimization without the rest of the Lucas solution?
That's, Okay. I'll take that one if you like. Not this time. It is only available currently with our mobile work execution software suite, John.
Okay. All right. Like I said, we're a little bit over on time. I'd like to thank everyone for participating and joining us here today. Like I said, we will be sending around a link, a copy of the presentation slides with a link to that video clip that was in the presentation. We will also be making a copy of the presentation replay available, and that should be in the next few days or so. So watch your email for those, the slides and the replay, as well as for information about our next webinar. Thank you again, everyone, for joining us.